Hey everybody, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV Company. My name is Will Warren, and today we're gonna be talking about the GeoPro 14FK. That's 14-foot front kitchen travel trailer. You guys are gonna love it. Yeah, it's a hot day. I'm hanging in the sunshine. You should hit me with the splash gun so I cool down. Won't you come on over? We can party till the sun's down. Let me buy you a drink while we're dancing to Blink. I could go for some Queen Bee too. Bass is going boom boom. Baby, if you're looking for some crazy, I'll tell you everybody's getting out of line. All right guys, now the GeoPro 14FK is a very lightweight trailer. This can be hauled by just about anything. Now, the dry weight on this coach is 2,100 pounds. So even most SUVs can haul this. Probably not your cars, maybe some minivans even out there, like that new Titan van, that could definitely haul this and then some. Now your GVWR is 2,917. So you have about 917 pounds of car you can put in this. But honestly, if you fill up the fresh water tank, if you put in your gear, you're probably not even gonna get close to the GVWR. This coach is a vacuum bonded coach, meaning that these walls here are bonded under extremely high pressure. They're very unlikely to delaminate. Aluminum superstructure throughout the entire coach, and overall just a very well used space inside. So let's go over some of these features. I can't wait to show you guys everything on this. Okay guys, we're gonna start off just at the very front of the 14FK. So one of the best things about this is right here. So you have this rack that can hold up to two bikes for you. I've seen a road bike on this. I actually have a road bike. My family and I, we love to go biking together. And so this is a fantastic feature. That way you don't have to worry about trying to store your bikes in your truck or in your SUV, whatever the case is, you have it right here. You also have two 20-pound propane tanks. Now that's more than enough for a coach this size, but it's good. It'll last you a very long time. You got a spot for a battery pack back here. You also have, here, come on this way. You have solar prep on this unit as well. And that's this little black plug right here. So you can wire up your battery directly to this plug, and then you plug in a portable solar panel, set it out in the sun, and it automatically charges your battery. And considering how small this camper is, a single battery would last you for quite a while. But if, let's say you're out camping and it's a little cold out, you run the furnace down, well in the morning, you set out your solar panel and it'll help to trickle charge that battery for you. Now, the cap on this is a solid fiberglass cap. You know, you can take a sledgehammer to this and it might dent it, but it's not gonna shatter on you. You also have this diamond plate as well, which is really tough. Of course, right here is where you're most likely to get a rock strike, and so they anticipate that and give you a little protection. You also have a little docking light here when you're hooking up at night or disconnecting at night, either way. Now let's go around to the other side. Now just because it is only 14 feet in length doesn't mean that they skimp on the amenities. So you have this electric awning here. You have an LED light strip underneath it. You also have your orange bug lamp, or scare light they call it. Of course that doesn't attract insects quite as much as like a white light does, so you can turn that on at night. You have this nice table right here for a prep or whatever you want to do. Oh, and the stairs. I'm sure you probably have all seen the stairs, but let's show you these things here. So these are what you call the solid step. And the reason for that, of course, is that they actually rest on the ground. So they don't have the give that your traditional steps do. So you simply prop this up like this. Whew, a little dusty. And it locks into place with this right here, and then you close your door. Now this door, it has a little bit of tension on it. You'll notice that it doesn't swing all the way and hit the wall when I push on it pretty hard. That's designed on purpose. It's designed not to slam in the wind. They call that a resistance hinge. You also have the screen door right here. And then this is cool. They give you, They give you a shade right here, but you can open that up to get more light in the coach. And so if we wanted to put the stairs down, which we do, we simply come here. This is that latch I was talking about. Pull that out and drop it down. Now also, these are adjustable. So if you have uneven ground or you need a little extra height because it just kind of slopes this way, you can adjust these legs so that way it'll fit whatever terrain you're on. drop it down like that. Close the door. It's important to know that this is a radius door, so there's no sharp corners up there, because when you drop this awning out, you can actually adjust the pitch of the awning, in which case a corner of this door has the potential to rub against that awning. And you can imagine a sharp corner against awning fabric will not end well. Last thing about this door, and this is just the door, guys. This is just the door area, is you have electronic key entry. So you can program this to whatever you like. That way, if you don't have your keys on you, you can still get into the coach. Also, the large grab handle. Okay, I swear that's it for the door. So over here, again, we have our prep table, and this can be removed just like so. It also happens to come with a grill, and there's a propane connect right down here. So there's a quick connect line. You plug it into here. Your grill sits right here where we had our table earlier, and you can connect that and grill away. You also happen to have power outlets here in case you want to run, I don't know, maybe some Christmas lights or something like that off of your awning. That'd be kind of sweet. Or any other appliances you want. Also, right below that, you have your off-road tire to give you extra clearance. You do have a spare, even though this is kind of a small camper, and these are also torsion axles. Now, all the windows on this coach are your frameless automotive type windows. So you can see there's no rubber gasket around the edge of this, and that's nice. That keeps that rubber fresher for longer. Also, they happen to open like this. They kind of pop up so you can have them open in the rain. And then directly below this window is a storage compartment with a little magnetic hinge, so it just holds itself like that. You won't be breaking those plastic hinges anymore. And down here you can see, here's your outside grill and storage compartment. All right, now we'll close this up and let's move over here to the back. So again, frameless windows, both of these do open. You can see that the roof is curved in radius to shed water off of it. And then that little black thing below the red running light, that's prepped for a backup camera. So we sell the InMotion Furion backup camera system, so you can use it while you're backing up, or if you're just driving down the road and you want to see what's going on behind you, you can flip it on and see what's behind the coach. Here, now come on this way. All right, it's a little tight back here. So this right here, of course, is your water heater. So this is a 6-gallon water heater. It'll run off of electric or off of propane, and it has a quick recovery rate of 16.2 gallons per hour. So it's a very, very quick recovery rate. This is your outside shower. It has a hot and cold feature to it, just like you would want it to have, like you have inside. Nice thing about these, assuming that my key decides to cooperate, here we go. Nice thing about this is you have a spot to hold it right here. Now you can get, once you get the temperature set where you want on the shower, same like on the inside, you can turn off the flow with this, turn it back on by flipping it that way. And that's a really nice feature. That way you're not having to get it right every time you want to turn it off and on. Right here, this is your city water connection. So this is where you have pressurized water, just like a garden hose or a vinyl hose is what I would recommend. This is where you'd fill your water tank at. This is where you connect your cable and your satellite, if you have a portable satellite with you. And then this right here is where you connect your power. And this has a little light right here, so when you connect your power cord to this, this will light up green and let you know that you are getting power from the pedestal to the camper. If you're plugged in and it's not green, that means for some reason or other, there's no power along that cord of yours. All right, now come on this way. Okay, right down here is your sewer connections. So this is your black tank flush, and then over here is your gray tank. Obviously, black tank is your toilet waste, and gray tank is your shower and sink. So now let's go inside, and I can show you where all that stuff is. All right, guys, come on in. Let me show you this tiny but well thought out space here. All right, now it is cozy in a 14-foot trailer, but it has everything you can need. So you have a sleeping space, you have a kitchen, you have a restroom, you even have a TV. I wanted to show you this right here. Right now, we're running this camper all off of battery power. And you notice the TV has power, and that may not seem very significant, but almost all TVs in campers are only 110. This is one of the few that actually works off of your battery. So even while you're camping, You can use this. It even has a little DVD player on the side, so you can play movies off of it if it's raining outside. You still have access to TV, even if you're boondocking. Camping without power is what that means. So up here, you have your radio, AM, FM, of course. You can even plug in an HDMI. You can plug in a USB cable, an auxiliary port. And then this as well, oh, and sorry, it has Bluetooth. I forgot to mention that. Also has equipped with Bluetooth. This is called the Wi-Fi Ranger. Now, a lot of times at a campsite, you're gonna be provided with free or complimentary Wi-Fi access. However, each campsite will be a little different on whether the signal's very strong. So if you're at a campsite and you're far away from their wireless router, you can turn this on and then you go through its menu on your phone and it will take that signal and amplify it here at your camper. So essentially it's a Wi-Fi extender or Wi-Fi repeater, either way, same kind of thing. And that gives you good internet access from the campsite right here at your coach. Now, around here, of course, we have, this is our table. So this can rotate if you want to have it like this or if you want to do it like this. This is also how you'll make it into a bed, and I'll show you that in just a second here. Up above, we have storage. This is your AC, and it's pretty bright in here, as you can tell, and that's because all these lights in here, they are all LED lights. Oh, and I'm sorry. Oh, great, it's Murray. So if you guys want to sit and find out who the baby daddy is, we can do that. But for right now, let's just turn that off for the moment. Okay, so now all your shades in here are the new roller style shade. So they pop up like that. Oh, sorry. There we go. And you can control exactly where they end up too. Now again, if you want to open up these windows, you simply twist like that and they pop open. And then this right here, of course, is your bed. So let me show you how to make this into that bed. So I'm gonna have Ox scoot back. Now it's pretty easy. The table becomes your other piece of the platform. You have the one bar that holds it in place and lets it spin. Also down here, now that we have a good shot of it, this is your furnace. And I can tell you that if you want to, you can set that all the way up to, what is it, max out at? Like 90 degrees and it'll cook you out of this thing. So, but to make it into a bed, we take our table slash platform and we put it down on these, there we go. We put it down on these little platforms here and then we fill in with these back cushions. Now, you can also remove these longer cushions here to give yourself a little more headroom. Now, I'm only 5'7", but I can lay on this very comfortably. I can go this way. There we go. Still have room for a pillow. If you're a little bit longer, you may have to lay on it kind of at a diagonal. All right, so that's how you make your bed. Now, when you wake up in the morning and you're ready for coffee and breakfast, of course, you're gonna go to your fridge. So this is a three-way refrigerator. It runs off of both AC and DC power. Now, typically, you only run it off of DC, your battery power, while you're driving down the road to keep it cool. Otherwise, you'll switch it over to shore power, AC, or you'll run it off of the propane system because it can do that too. It has a built-in little fridge. They also give you a little bit of a toilet chemical complimentary so you can make sure your camper doesn't stink. And then of course, this is your fridge area here as well. This packet contains all of your remote controls and things like that. You have a pantry space down here. You can see right there, plenty of space to put Rubbermaid containers for pantry, or I guess you could also use it as a closet if you wanted to. Three drawers down here for utensils or whatever else you want to put in there. And then let's move over to what you have to do after you drink your morning coffee, and that's go to the restroom, right? Okay guys, now let me show you the restroom. Now this is what you call either the triple threat or the triple benefit. It depends on your perspective. So this right here is everything, right? Here you can shower, here you can shave, you can, well, you know what I'm talking about. You can do that too in here all at once. So this, of course, is your toilet. Now you can use a little lever back here to fill it up with a little bit of water and then do your business and then pull the lever all the way and it'll flush for you right down into your black tank. Now this is your shower. It does have a very, very important feature though. Right down here, this little blue tube is called the shower miser. Now when you're heating up your shower water, right, you're just letting a bunch of cold water run through it until you get up to the hot water, you get up to temperature you like. What this allows you to do is there's a valve. It's hard to see it, but it's right here, right? So you can open it or close it. So right now it's closed. And what that means is that the hot water, the water's gonna keep running through here, just like that. And it's actually gonna circulate back to your water tank instead of going down the drain. And this blue tube will eventually change colors, or I should say it lightens up to show you a bunch of lines on it. And then you know, great, I got hot water. And then you can turn this on and adjust and finally tune the temperature then with these knobs here. So that's the nice feature on this is that it saves your water. And when you have 26 gallons of fresh water, you're gonna need to be careful with what you use. You don't wanna waste a bunch of it just getting your shower up to temperature. So this right here, of course, has the same feature that we had on the outside shower as well. Once you get that temperature finally tuned where you want, what you'll probably do, what most RVers do, is they'll rinse off and then they'll press this button here, just like that, to shut off the water, lather up, press it again, rinse it off with nice warm water, not cold water, and then you're done with your shower. Now let's talk about this over here, because this is your, of course, the other important part is the kitchen. So they want to save space in this, of course. I mean, it's 14 feet. So up here you have storage. Now normally you'd probably also have a microwave up here and then you'd have an oven. But what they did is they put those two things into one. So this is a convection microwave. So it'll do everything that your oven will do and it'll do everything a microwave will do. As a matter of fact, it'll reduce your cook time on the oven function down to about half what it would take normally in an oven for you. Now, of course, being a kitchen, you're gonna need some storage. So you have two drawers for you right here and you have access underneath the sink and also storage right here. You have, of course, an outlet so you can plug in any kind of appliances. If you want to make a smoothie for the morning, you can bring along your blender. Hot and cold water in your stainless steel sink. And this doubles as your cooktop and as countertop space. So right now, obviously, it's set up for countertop space. When you're ready to cook on your gas range, you flip that up and you have a three burner system and this becomes your backsplash. So, and you just a little sparker right here. I don't know if you can hear that snapping, but that's how you ignite it. And that, you guys, is the 14FK in a nutshell. You guys, I thank you for watching our video. I really hope you enjoyed learning about the 14FK and the GeoPros a little bit. My name is Will, and if you have questions, you can feel free to contact me. We're up here at the Great Outdoors RV in Evans, Colorado. And our phone number is 970-313-4337. And our email address, if you want to email us, is sales@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. Thank you all for watching. I'll catch you guys next time I'm in town.